Shall we start if you don't have anything to ask? Do you want me to start?
Yes.
Yes, hocam.
As you are following from our previous classes, we are starting to evaluate the impact of tax to the system, how it is going to be, whether it is fairly contributing to the producer,
Hoca,
consumers. Yes, please.
Sorry, just before you start, about the grades, did you upload them or not? Yeah.
No grades, but the results is already uploaded to the system. You didn't get your results.
On Teams or on the?
Yeah, I put on the university portal. I uploaded okay. To the university. You didn't check it?
No, not yet.
You don't know your results?
No.
If you don't any access to the system, you can write me email, then I will reply you, or you write me from these Teams, okay?
Okay, hocam, thank you.
Okay. As I said to you, we have already started to evaluate the surplus, consumer surplus, producer surplus. And also we added this tax to the system to see how it is going to affect and change the welfare, consumer welfare and producer gain because of the elasticity and the position of the supply and demand curves. You are understanding it is affecting and changing the contribution of tax to the system, to the government, to the, let's say, agencies who are collecting this tax, is going to be effectively used or not. We are questioning this with this surplus. Therefore, today we are also questioning and evaluating and, of course, analyzing a little bit more. Then I will give you some exercises, or we will do some exercises after this. As you are observing here, we have the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity, and of course we want to know without tax how it is going to be, and with tax what will be happen. Okay. This is the consumer surplus, the purple area. And there are two right angled triangles here. The first one is the consumer surplus and the inversely illustrated triangle, right angle triangle, is the producer surplus. As you see, we put here the world price, which is above the equilibrium for this country, and it is, of course, a little bit higher. The price before trade, it is supposed to be is in equilibrium, and after trade, which is realized, the international trade, the price is supposed to be increased. Sometimes it is decreasing, sometimes it is increasing, but of course, it is important to know how it is going to affect and change the welfare of the consumers, and of course the producer surplus will be affected, or what is the position after this international trade, and of course the tax or tariff is going to be applied to the system. Whenever you have question, you ask me. If you don't, then I will go further. As I said to you, the price which is increased after the trade is affecting the welfare of the consumers. And this is, of course, not good. For this case, there are several options and several applications that we can put into the system to see the impact of these price changes after the trade, international trade realized. Because we suppose international trade usually contributing to the welfare positively, but sometimes it is, of course, affecting and changing the economy negatively because of the tax. If the tax is higher applied, as you are observing here, the price is going to be shifted above the equilibrium, and it is, of course, reducing the welfare. And this is, of course, consumer welfare, and this is, of course, not good for the social economical aspect of this trade or international trade relations. You see, this should be exported here after the price realized, trade relations realized, and of course the price going to be higher, then we should reduce it or remove it by exporting to the other nations for being able to manage reasonable price for the consumers. The area, if it is domestic supply here, which is illustrated, there is higher price and there is, of course, surplus in the economy. It should be exported because of equilibrium price, as it is illustrated, of this supply and demand intersection. Above this area is supposed to be surplus and below is the scarcity, as you know. And here we suppose there is some surpluses in the economy and it should be removed or exported to the other nations or other destinations. And producer surplus before trade, as you are observing here, was sufficiently given, but consumer surplus is supposed to be before trade was acceptable level, but after price, which is increased trade, which is increased after the trade, is going to be higher, and of course reducing the consumer surplus to the right angle triangle A, area A. Then if you want to get some outcomes of this given scenario, before trade the consumer surplus is A and B, and of course after trade is going to be reduced to A. And here there is consumer surplus reduction, or there is some loss on the consumer surplus, which is the area B. The area B is reduced because of this price changes after the trade, which is increased and reduced the consumer surplus. And producer surplus was C, and after the trade, as you see here, it is shifted to the higher level and becomes B plus C plus D. And this is, of course, good for the producer. Unfortunately, it is not good to the system because it is affecting negatively the consumer surplus. And here the transfer, some reasonable transfer, resource transfer realized from consumers to producers. And this is then, of course, not good for the economy, for the whole economy, because welfare is decreasing and some reasonable resources or capital or some money or some, let's say, amount of resources transferred to the producers and consumer welfare is reduced. And total surplus is supposed to be before trade A plus B plus C, and after the trade it is becoming A plus B plus C plus D, which is included and added to the system with the amount of this area, this triangle D, where the exportable amount of goods is illustrated. And of course, total surplus is here is only the D because of this trade relation. And as I mentioned to you, sometimes trade relations contributing to increase the producer gain, and sometimes it is contributing to increase the consumer welfare because of the price changes. If the price is reduced after the trade relations, we are supposing consumer welfare is enlarged and increased. And if the price is increased after the trade relations, we are expecting that this will contribute and, of course, increase the producer gain at the end of this scenario. Therefore, we have to learn to manage this with these graphical illustrations. From the first look, we have to determine what is happening here when the price goes up and when the price falls down. Then you will understand price fall will contribute to the consumer surplus, and price when the price goes up, it is of course increasing and contributing to the producer gain. Once again, we are illustrating here this equilibrium. But now we have the price after trade. As you are observing here, the domestic quantity supplied is now is reduced, but the surplus is increased, and we are expecting here to import some goods to cover this scarcity, because we are supposing that we have some scarcity in the system. As you see, price after trade now is reduced, and it is expected some importable goods is realized and cover this reduction. Let's see how it is going to be. Consumer surplus before trade, producer surplus before trade. Producer surplus after trade, as you see, consumer surplus after trade has become enlarged ABD area, and the producer surplus is reduced to C. It was before trade C plus B for the producer, but after trade relations where the price reduced, the consumer surplus is increased to A plus B plus D. Therefore, this is good for the economy because consumer surplus is somehow is enlarged. But on the other side, when we are looking to the producer side, the producer production is reducing here. And therefore, we have to manage these differences and this distribution of these resources for maintaining the sustainable economical model, because if we are creating more importable goods for contributing to the consumer surplus, it is good for the consumer, but on the other side, it is not good for the producer because it is reducing the production. Therefore, the supply side of the economy is affected here, and we have to manage this in this direction for both parties, for increasing or maintaining the sustainable model at equilibrium level. Therefore, here we can put some tax to shift the importable goods, or to collect some taxes for the economy to shift the producer price a little bit higher, at least to approach to the equilibrium for maintaining reasonable production for the producer, and of course for offering and giving some reasonable products to the consumers, and of course price to the consumers for maintaining the consumer surplus and the producer surplus at desired level where it is near to the equilibrium. If it is not done, as you see, one party is always suffering at the end of the day if the price is going up or if the price is falling down. Either it is falling or increasing, consumer or producer is affected. Therefore, we have to find the reasonable way for maintaining sustainable model where the producer surplus and producer production operation process is maintained and not reduced, and consumer surplus is also reasonable with the reasonable prices given and of course maintained. Here again, when we are looking to this trade where the price reduced the consumer surpluses increase from A, before trade it was A, and from after the trade is going to be enlarged to A plus B plus D. And
he left.
Hello, Ben. Can you hear anything?
Not really. From my end, can't hear anything.
Anything else? Is it on there? I think our meeting has started.